legal ramifications of those other interesting options that are being thrown out have not been investigated, but I got a new job, don't I? Alright, come on down!
If the person who owns the property doesn't care that you're being there, then it's not trespassing. You can have it just fine. If the person who does own the property cares about you being there and asks you to leave and you don't leave, technically it's trespass, but they can kind of get squirrely about it, and maybe they say you resisted and installed, or, you know, kind of start trumping stuff up. So theoretically, it's just a small misdemeanor and it's no big deal, but it can escalate pretty quickly if you're not careful, so our actions would definitely want to be on the up and up. Any business is going to be private property. They're definitely going to react hostily to it. What makes things interesting to me is we have the right to assemble. If we're not allowed to do it on private property, then we have to be allowed to do it on public property. Public property is the people's property. What do we have to get the king's permission to be able to generally assemble? That's not America. So, I mean, we have the right to assemble. We should be able to do it anywhere on public property. That's the whole point.
What about all these HUD properties sitting around Norfolk that are vacant lots?
Technically the bank's property.
Oh, great, even better.
Oh, here we go.
Hi, I'm Laura again. My idea about the private property was actually to get permission from a sympathetic property owner, not to just, like, go randomly occupy somebody's property.
So, let's do a quick vibes check here. We're going to avoid private property unless we have the blessing of the owner or unless it's bank's property. Is that what everybody is kind of spitting here? If we get a thumbs up for private, great, but if we don't get a thumbs up, and it's not like bank property or some other clearly enemy dickhead party, then we're going to avoid private. So we've heard suggestions for almost every park in the city right now. Anybody have a good reason why one's better than another? After Dave says this?
Point of information, we are checking out some private land at the corner of, well, I'm not going to say it right now, but it's not too far away. Another option we looked into was the Unitarian Universalist Church. Unfortunately, but goodly, they operate on a similar model as we do, participatory democracy, that runs too slowly to get us in there as emergency refugees. We will have them put it through their process so that if we, you know, a few weeks from now we need a place, that may be an option. If anyone knows of any other churches that may be friendly to us, that may have some law, you know, grounds around the church where we can pitch tents, please investigate it. Please let us know. Anyone know of any friendly church that may give us sanctuary? That could be a great option.
Okay. You, then you.
Hello, everybody. My name's Richard. The reason I recommend Lafayette Park is because they got a few shelters there, the lean-tos with the open sides, and I believe there is bathroom facilities there.
There is, but they lock after dark. But it's you know.
I can climb.
Who's next?
There's plenty of trees.
I know that in Virginia Beach they have not allowed like anyone to get permits, but I think some groups, like for example, I went to Friends School and going to Friends Meeting for a long time. When I went there, from kindergarten to senior year, and I'm pretty sure that a lot of people on the Friends Meeting, you know, committee would be interested in, you know, maybe at least talking about maybe supporting it. Might not be able to lend a site per se, but you know, they probably would know of, you know, other sympathetic groups who might be able to.
Okay, real quick, let me just try to refocus this conversation a little bit. Everybody has free will here, everybody can do what they want. What we're actually talking about is what might we occupy right now. So can I see a show of hands for everybody that, if possible, they will occupy somewhere tonight? Looks like we're in the double digits. That works for me. Okay, so it looks like at least a dozen, maybe more. Okay, so let's get back into this conversation. We'll get right there. Come on over.
One and then two.
So just a quick clarification, where might we go tonight? And there's still time for further discussion about where we might go after that.
Hey, hi again, everyone. As to Rex, as